Hello and greetings from Iceland, but it's time to do another volcano update. And it's not only about the floods this weekend that could have led to an eruption in Grimsvötn. This update is also about the earthquakes under Katla Volcano and the earthquakes up north on the Tjörnes fracture zone. And of course, the action that started just yesterday offshore. So it's plenty to choose from today. But let's start where we left off last week, or when the glacial flood was about to peak. And it's still a reason to stay alert, since those floods can trigger a Grimsvötn eruption. But so far, we have only got a small number of earthquakes, so it looks as Grimsvötn will be on hold for a while longer. But we can't rule out an eruption, of course. Like we can never rule out the volcano Katla that sent us a few teasers early Sunday morning in the form of earthquakes, or under ice cauldron number 10 and 11, but we have like 20 of them up there in various shapes and forms. And the Katla earthquake made it to the news with the message that we should be on the lookout by this river, since the earthquakes might have triggered a flood that could be on the way down. But now, on Monday, we can't see anything of that kind, and the total number of earthquakes in Katla in 2022 is still within the average. But the spike that we have been seeing for the last 2-3 weeks can of course change that fast. And I have to say that experts are concerned, as I can see through the interviews. It might have to do with the unusual spikes on the tremor chart. So they seem to believe that there is something more going on than usual. Like in 2011, when a glacier flood swept away this bridge. So this volcano, Katla, should not be underestimated. It is long overdue, and in fact it's just a ticking time bomb, like I described in my full video about the town Vík by the glacier capped volcano, and I'm linking to it and recommend it, or the beautiful town just by the volcano. So let's move up north to the Tjörnes fracture zone, where over 10,000 earthquakes occurred just over a month ago, but it seems to be starting again at the same location, or just by the island Grimsey. And it is noticeable that like before the last earthquake swarm, we see earthquakes in the far north first. So it's still a lot of tension there. And I'm linking to a video that I made recently about this fault and what it can do. And today's story ends on the Reykjanes Peninsula. First, I need to mention the magnitude 3.5 earthquake that occurred there just recently, or at this suspicious location that I mentioned just last week as one of the potential places for the next eruption to occur around there. And this has become one of the most active spots on the peninsula when it comes to earthquakes. Only a few kilometers from the magma dike that fed the two eruptions on Fagradalsfjall mountain. So the activity is moving closer to the city, which is bad, but away from the fishery town Grindavík, which is good. And speaking about that town, again I must say that it's very surprising that we ain't getting any information about the magma intrusion that occurred almost under the town just 6 months ago. I can understand it up to a limit since then we have had an eruption elsewhere and a meteor storm around that event. But it doesn't change the fact that things were tense around the town just 6 months ago, and most of my videos since back then were covering evacuation plans, lava barriers and such. But then we got lucky, the next eruption came up further away from the town, and the business as usual in Grindavík. But the question remains, has the land subsided, or can land uplift still be detected around the town? And furthermore, and perhaps most importantly, how does the three magma intrusions by Grindavík and the Blue Lagoon connect to the larger picture, as for the plumbing under there? And I'm sure that many of the local house owners are asking the question, what is going on under my house? And I think it's a fair question. But overall, it would not surprise me if we are looking at a new chapter on the way now. A chapter that might consist of earthquakes only, or end up with an eruption. And we might be looking at something in the making just now, or this rather strong earthquake swarm on the Reykjanes Ridge, or actually the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. There is however nothing new about this location. The seabed there has its own story to tell from the volcanoes under there, and the islands that have been popping up every now and then, coming and going. But will this unrest migrate to the peninsula? It's possible. I've seen such a trend numerous times. But so far, it's all calm there. Unusually calm, actually. And we know that it ain't gonna hold. We are entering this long period of unrest, and we can only guess where the next eruption will take place. The volcano Katla is ready, like the volcano Hekla, Grimsvötn, Bárðarbunga, and Askja, or all of the most dangerous volcanic systems in Iceland. So to top this all, we have the unrest on the Reykjanes Peninsula that will outlive the next 3-4 generations perhaps. So this is a situation that we simply haven't seen here in Iceland before, or so many volcanoes are ready, and all this unrest going on at the same time. So all we can do is to wait and be prepared, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.